The U.S.-led coalition is closing in on the last sliver of ISIS-held territory in Syria, but militants are digging in, and a victory many thought could happen any day now remains elusive. The battles are raging around Baghouz al-Falkaini. Our CNN crew wound up too close to the crossfire for comfort and had to actually pull back when the situation became too dangerous. Ben Wedeman brings us this exclusive report from Eastern Syria.
So we have to leave our position now because the morning began with a heavy exchange of machine gun fire followed by loud explosions. We went up to the roof and started to take incoming rounds. Then some sort of explosive device landed just next to the building we were in. Because it appears that there's been a serious ISIS counterattack, and we've seen some of the SDF troops pulling back as this goes on, although some of the officers are urging them to go forward. But what ISIS fighters were doing were taking advantage of the early morning fog, which is often their tactic, to try to make advances, and it appears indeed they have, and that's why we have to move back. I'm Ben Wedeman, CNN, reporting from the front lines in eastern Syria.
The top U.S. military man in the Middle East says whenever those ISIS fighters are presumably ousted, it will not mean that they have been beaten. Ryan Brown is live at the Pentagon with more. Yeah, U.S. General of Central Command Joseph Otell was saying, look, the mission will not be over. In fact, we'll have to continue to put military pressure on ISIS.
Well, that's right, Amra. General Votel telling our CNN's Barbara Starr that military pressure will need to continue even after it loses its last enclave, which you saw just there in that report where it's desperately clinging on to. General Votel saying he agrees with U.S. intelligence estimates that thousands of ISIS fighters remain in Iraq and Syria dispersed, but with some capability left. So that remaining ISIS group will have to be contained with military pressure. And he acknowledged that doing so is going to be a lot more difficult without U.S. troops on the ground to help do that. But he said President Trump has ordered all U.S. troops out of Syria, and he is going to follow his orders. But he notes that keeping pressure on ISIS is going to be a lot more difficult without U.S. forces there on the ground.
Yeah, that will be a very challenging, to say the least. Ryan Brown, appreciate it. Live for us there at the Pentagon.